Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up a Minecraft Bedrock server on Ubuntu. For this guide, you'll need to be running at least Ubuntu 20 or newer. Additionally, if you're running this from within your home network, you'll want to make sure your device has a static IP address. We have a guide linked below on how you can do this. Once you're ready to go, open up the terminal on your Ubuntu device. Before we set up the Minecraft Bedrock server, we should ensure our operating system is up to date. To do this, first update the package list by typing in sudo apt update. Once the package list is updated, we can upgrade any out of date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. Our next step is to install the software we require to run the Minecraft Bedrock server. To do this, type in sudo apt install kel wget unzip grep screen and open SSL, then type in hyphen y. Most of these packages will be used to grab and download the latest version of the Minecraft Bedrock server to Ubuntu. However, before we start using these tools, let's create a user that the Minecraft server will run under. To do this, type in sudo user add hyphen m mc server and then press enter. Next, to ensure that our current user can easily interact with the files owned by this new user, type in sudo usermod hyphen a capital G mc server space dollar sign symbol and then user all in uppercase. To ensure this script change is read in by the rest of the system, reboot by typing in sudo space reboot and pressing enter. Once your Ubuntu system has finished restarting, begin by creating a directory to store the Minecraft Bedrock server. To do this, type in sudo space mkdir space hyphen p space slash home slash mc server slash Minecraft online bedrock and then press enter. With the directory now created, change it by typing in cd slash home slash mc server slash Minecraft online bedrock and pressing enter. To save the hassle of having to load up the Minecraft Bedrock server website every time, we'll use a bit of kel and grep magic to ensure we get the latest download link directly from the terminal. To do this, type in download online URL, all in uppercase, followed by the equal sign, then the dollar sign symbol, then open bracket, kel, hyphen h, double quote, accept, hyphen encoding, colon symbol, identity, double quote, space, hyphen capital H, space, double quote, accept, hyphen language, colon symbol, en, double quote, space, hyphen s space hyphen capital L space hyphen capital A space double quote Mozilla slash 4.0 open bracket compatible semicolon MSIE space 6.0 semicolon Windows space NT space 5.1 semicolon space bedrock underline updater close bracket. Follow this up with a double quote and then https colon symbol slash slash minecraft.net slash en hyphen us slash download slash server slash bedrock slash pipe symbol. Follow this up with grep hyphen o single quote https dot asterisk symbol slash bin hyphen linux slash dot star dot zip followed by a single quote and a close bracket. Essentially what this command is doing is grabbing the download page for the Bedrock server and then using grep to grab the download link. The result of this command is stored within the download online URL variable we specify at the start of the line. This line only looks long because we must specify a few headers that the website expects to set the connection. We can verify that the download link was successfully grabbed by typing in echo space dollar sign symbol download underline URL all in uppercase and then pressing enter. If it has worked properly, you should now see the download link displayed within the terminal. Our next step is to use wget to download the server files that we just grabbed the link for. We can do this by typing in sudo space wget space hyphen capital U space double quote Mozilla slash 4.0 space open bracket compatible semicolon MSIE 6.0 semicolon space Windows NT 5.1 5.1 semicolon bedrock hyphen updater, followed by a close bracket and then a double quote. Next, type in $ symbol download underlying URL, all in uppercase, followed by the hyphen, capital O, space dot slash bedrock hyphen server dot zip, and then pressing enter. With the Bedrock server archive now downloaded to your Ubuntu machine, let's extract it by typing in sudo space unzip space dot slash bedrock hyphen server dot zip space hyphen d space dot slash. With the Minecraft Bedrock server now extracted to your Ubuntu system, we can delete the zip file we downloaded by typing in sudo space rm space dot slash bedrock hyphen server dot zip and pressing enter. With the server now installed, a next step is to write a couple of scripts that will make managing this server a little easier. This first script we'll be writing is called start online server.sh and will contain a few commands that start the server within a separate screen. By storing it within these screens, you'll be able to access it at any time through the command line without needing to keep it running in your current session. Begin writing the script by typing in sudo nano start online server.sh. Now within this file, start it off by typing in hashtag exclamation mark slash user slash bin slash env space bash. This line basically helps the command line understand how it should interpret this file. Next, type in server underline path equals sign slash home slash mc server slash minecraft underline bedrock slash. This defines a bash variable, so we don't have to specify the path multiple times. Next, type in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen dm capital S space mc bedrock space slash bin slash bash space hyphen c space double quote ld underline library underline path equals $ symbol server underline path space $ symbol curly bracket open server underline path close curly bracket bedrock underline server followed by a double quote. This line is what will start the Minecraft Bedrock server on Ubuntu and then store it within a screen called MC Bedrock. Next, type in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen R capital D MC Bedrock space hyphen capital X multi-user space on. Then type on a new line slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen D space MC Bedrock space hyphen X space ACL add space root and then press enter. These lines allow us to take over this screen as the root user. Once you are done, press Ctrl plus X and then Y and then enter to save and quit. Now make this new script executable by typing in sudo spaceship mod space plus X space dot slash start online server dot sh and then press enter. Our next step is to write a script that will safely stop your Minecraft Bedrock server on Ubuntu. To start this process, type in sudo space nano space stop online server dot sh. Start off this file by typing in hashtag exclamation mark slash user slash bin slash env space bash. After that line, type in slash user slash bin slash screen space hyphen capital R lowercase d space mc bedrock space hyphen capital X space stop space double quote stop space slash R double quote. With this line, we are sending a message to the MC Bedrock screen that we created. This message simply says stop. The Minecraft Bedrock server will receive this and safely shut down. Once done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then enter. Like the start script, make this one executable as well by typing in sudo space chip mod space plus X space dot slash stop underline server dot sh. As we have been running all these commands using the super user, we now need to ensure that they are now all owned by the MC server user. To do this, type in sudo chown space hyphen capital R space MC server colon space slash home slash MC server. Our next step is to create a service file that will help manage the Minecraft Bedrock server running on your Ubuntu system. Begin writing this file by typing in sudo space nano slash etc slash systemd slash system slash mcbedrock.service. Now in this file, type in open square bracket unit close square bracket. This defines a new service unit file. Next, type in description equal sign followed by Minecraft space bedrock space server. This helps make it easier to identify what this service is for. After that, type in wants equals network hyphen online dot target, and then after equals network hyphen online dot target. These two lines ensures Ubuntu will only start up our Minecraft bedrock server once networking is available. After that, type in open square bracket service close square bracket to begin defining your service. Next, type in type equals forking. We need to set the type to forking because our Minecraft server will be started by our script and not ran directly. After this, type in user equals MC server followed by group equals MC server. These two lines ensures our Minecraft Bedrock server will be ran by the user we created earlier in this guide. Next, type in exec start equals sign slash user slash bin slash bash space slash home slash mc server slash minecraft unline bedrock slash start unline server dot sh. After that, type exec stop equals sign slash user slash bin slash bash space slash home slash mc server slash minecraft unline bedrock slash stop unline server dot sh. These two lines use the start and stop script we wrote earlier to start and stop the Minecraft Bedrock server running on your Ubuntu system. Now, type in working directory equals sign slash home slash mc server slash Minecraft underline bedrock slash. This line tells the service to work within the directory where we saved the Minecraft server to earlier. Now, type in restart equals always. This simply gets a service manager to restart your server if it ever crashes. After this, type in timeout start sec equals 600. This forces the system manager to wait 600 seconds before classifying the server as failed to start. Now under this, define the install section by typing in open square bracket install close square bracket. Finally, type in wanted by equals sign multi hyphen user dot target. With this all done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. Before you start up the server, you'll probably want to configure it. To do this, type in sudo nano server.properties and press Enter. Within this file, you'll find numerous different options. Be sure to read the comments to see how you can configure them and what those options do to your Minecraft Bedrock server. If you make any changes, be sure to save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. Now let's get our Minecraft Bedrock server to start when Ubuntu does by typing in sudo space systemctl space enable space mcbedrock. Once enabled, start up the server itself by typing in sudo space systemctl space start space mcbedrock. At this point, you should successfully have your Minecraft Bedrock server up and running on Ubuntu. You can verify this by typing in sudo space systemctl space status space mcbedrock. If everything has worked properly, you should see the status marked as active running, like it is in our example. At this point, you can now connect to your game server if you want it. If you forgot the IP address of your machine, you can get this by typing in hostname space hyphen capital I. In our example, you can see our local IP address is 192.168.0.8. As long as the device is on the same network, they'll be able to join using this address. Before we go and join this server, let us show you how you can interact with the Minecraft server's command line interface. To interact with this, we'll need to type in sudo space screen space hyphen r space mc server slash mc bedrock. This restores the screen the server's running in to the current foreground. You can now use this to type in any Minecraft command that you wanted. For example, if we wanted to give our player OP privileges, we'll type in OP followed by the username, which in our case was def1droid. This user will need to be connected to the server when you run this command. Before you finish up, you will need to detach this screen. To do this, press Ctrl plus A, then Ctrl D. failure to do this will mean the service will not be able to properly manage your Minecraft server. Let's finally show our server in action by clicking play, servers, scrolling down to the bottom of the list, hitting add server, typing in a name for our server such as PyMyLifeUp, and then setting the IP address to our Ubuntu device. We then can hit the play button to connect directly to the Minecraft server. At this point, you have successfully set up the Minecraft Bedrock server on your Ubuntu system. If you want to access this server from outside your home network, you will need to port forward ports 19132 and 19133. You can also use services such as Tailscale to remotely connect to your server without having to port forward, but these require some additional configuration that we won't be covering in this guide. If you like this tutorial, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.